Have you ever wanted to have the most amazing dream wardrobe ever in the entire world of the universe? Because we don't know if there's aliens out there. Well, you're in luck because today we're going to be going through how to get your dream wardrobe and the most perfect style that matches your personality perfectly. This has taken me quite a while to figure out, and I feel like it's still a journey, like because your personality can change, your mind can change. So if it changes or if you like different aesthetics, that's totally fine and it's completely normal. So just keep that in mind. Plan it out where you buy a couple items or even one item this week and buy a couple more items the next week or a couple weeks later. It will definitely help with overspending or splurging, and you can totally find items that are so much cheaper than the expensive items, like finding Louis Vuitton bags, getting them actually at Louis Vuitton, or versus getting them off of different websites where it's exactly the same and it looks like Louis Vuitton, except it's cheaper because it's not from the Louis Vuitton store. You know what I'm saying? You can always find cheap alternatives to the stuff you love. Yeah, let's get right into the video. So the first thing is pretty basic. Go on Pinterest, find the stuff you like, find inspiration you might like, and make a whole board for it. And then go through your board and you'll start to find patterns of stuff you love. You'll start to find patterns of certain objects or certain clothes that you'll like or aesthetics. And if you have different aesthetics, again, that's totally okay. It might take a little longer to build your wardrobe because of all the different aesthetic stuff you have to get, but it's still possible and it's still awesome. Making a board on Pinterest of all these clothing items and styles that you love will help you find what you truly like and where you need to put your focus on when shopping and, building your wardrobe. So once you figure out your style from Pinterest, you can ask yourself some questions that would help you figure out where to put your money, how to get this style and get this goal of beautiful wardrobe. So the first question you should ask is, what is most important to you? By that, I mean, what clothing item is most important? Are you really into shoes? Are you really into tops? What do you care about most when it comes to making an outfit? Or another way to ask this is, where do you tend to express yourself most when making an outfit? Is it in your accessories, like the hat or the jewelry? Or is it in the t-shirt? Do you like to wear graphic tees? Or do you like to wear bands on your t-shirts? How do you like to express yourself? Do you like to wear crazy pants with patterns on them? Or are you a sneakerhead and absolutely love shoes and that's where you put all your effort? For me personally, I love tops. I express myself most with tops. I love expressing what I like. I love expressing, how I feel or my opinions with things with shirts. And I love the different designs. I feel like you can do so much with shirts than other items. So that's kind of where I typically put in my effort and my money. And I have very basic pants. They're all pretty much the same. Nothing fancy like corduroy pants or plaid pants, just very basic jeans. And I wear the same three accessories over and over again. So, but I love bright, colorful, creative tops. So knowing where I put my effort, my money, and how tops are most important to me, I can figure out how to create an outfit where the top is speaking the most in the fit. You know what I'm saying? So if you're creating a fit, you could have basic jeans, basic shoes, and then have this most extravagant top, a very crazy top. So instead of buying these crazy pants, crazy shoes, crazy accessories, instead just buy basic stuff like basic jeans that you can wear with everything, basic shoes, basic accessories, but put in the creativity and the stuff that you like to express yourself in, like with me, tops. So if you're a sneakerhead, buy more basic shirts and pants so that you can pair outfits with anything and then get really creative, unique shoes and have that as your unique item. It helps a lot when it comes to making outfits because you'll be more comfortable because you're expressing yourself in something that matters to you more and something that you just like more. And instead of trying to create this absolute model outfit, which you don't need to be stylish, you just need that one unique item with the rest being basic in order for it to be style. That's just how I see it, honestly. And this is just to get a start with your wardrobe because basics are definitely where you want to put your money more than that those unique things, those unique accessories that you're probably never going to wear because you just don't feel comfortable with it and it's not something you would wear on a casual day. So getting those basics down and getting the unique items with something like shoes or tops or whatever you like to express yourself in will definitely help with creating a wardrobe that's very comfortable for you and that you will actually wear every day. So like this style here, you can tell the person is putting all of their effort into the pants. That is where they are expressing themselves. It's a basic white long sleeve top. It's very basic and very basic Converse. And she put in glasses as well and styled her hair. But you can tell that her effort and her expression is coming from her jeans. Or like this outfit. I know I switched to the other side. Let's just pretend that didn't happen. But this outfit, you can tell she puts her effort into the top. The top is what makes it a unique outfit. She's even wearing sweatpants, but she's wearing sweatpants, basic shoes, but the top is what makes it unique and cool and style. And the color coding. But that's a different video. To figure out what is most important to you in an outfit, you could also track what you are spending on the most when it comes to clothes. Do you like to shop for shoes the most, or do you tend to lean towards the tops, or do you like going for the jeans? And what do you like shopping for the least? That can kind of show you where you will typically get basic clothes. Like, I hate shopping for pants, and I don't really like putting in any effort with pants, so I have very basic jeans. The second question you can ask yourself, okay, first of all, the first question was kind of a load, but the second one is, what is your aesthetic? And if you don't know your aesthetic, that is where the Pinterest board comes in, kind of figuring out what you like and what you love. And once you figure out what your aesthetic is, then you can find the common clothing items that go with that aesthetic. So for example, the Dark Academia aesthetic has those V-neck vests, the V-neck sweaters, or the Soft Girl aesthetic has the bright color floral skirts, floral cardigans. This will help to find items you'll actually love and you'll actually use, given it's the aesthetic that you love. The third thing is to get the basics first. I know I kind of covered this in the first thing. Okay, I'm getting weird now. The third thing to do is to get the basics first. I kind of covered this in the first question that I asked you, but getting basics, it's a very safe mood. Okay, it's a mood. It's a very safe move. And when I say getting basics, I don't mean to dress like a basic girl, whatever you have in your mind with that. I'm saying get basic clothing, like blue jeans or white and black basic t-shirts or basic shoes, kind of stuff like that. Or get the basics from the aesthetic that you love so that you can start building your wardrobe safely instead of starting with those crazy unique items, because really, style is about pairing the basics with a couple unique items. So the basics are what's really, really important. And it also helps you just be really, really comfortable with yourself and your style. So it will be more likely that this style becomes permanent in your life than a thing that you do once a month. I personally found out that I love the streetwear aesthetic. I don't go with it all the time, obviously, but once I figured that out, I got some basic stuff like from that aesthetic, like the basic graphic tees and biker shorts. I got a couple pairs of each, and because of that, I am able to pair multiple outfits with just those three t-shirts and three biker shorts. So, and the fourth thing is, overall, it's really just about experimenting. Experiment with stuff you like, experiment with different outfits, go out in public and make yourself uncomfortable to get out of your comfort zone so that you can see what works, what doesn't, what you're comfortable in, because you probably won't get this the first try. You probably won't find what you really truly love the first try, but if you're experimenting and you keep trying, you're gonna eventually find stuff that you really love and you're gonna be able to express yourself in very creative and beautiful ways through your outfit. One thing that I love to do is I like to take pictures of all of the outfits I create in a full-length mirror and then save it in a photo album in my phone. phone so that I can look through to see what I like, what I don't like, to kind of find out the vibe that I'm going for. And it also helps when you're like, I'm not sure what I want to wear. You can go through the photo album and be like, oh yeah, that's a cute outfit. I can wear that today. You know what I'm saying? It's like that Barbie wardrobe thing, you know? Barbie Life in the Dream House, she has that computer where she can match all her outfits. It's the same thing. Those are all the tips I have for you today. I really hope you figure out your dream wardrobe and your personal style, and I will see y'all next time. Check it out.